Munoz. We're doing something a little different. We've got 20 questions we're going to see if we can get through. Nothing too crazy. And, you know, some questions you might have short answers, some you might have longer.
Okay. All right.
MacGyver or A-Team?
Ooh, these kind of questions.
Yeah.
Oh, man, I like them both.
If
I had to pick, I would go with MacGyver because he has a solution for every problem. And even with, like, toothpicks and, like, bobby pins and stuff like that. I love that. I love how he's resourceful like that. That's how I am inside the fight. You know, I'm kind of resourceful with what I have. I use to the best of my ability, just like MacGyver.
That's a good answer. I've got some entertainment questions. We'll stay with this team. So Star Wars, yes or no?
Yes.
Good answer.
Yes.
I'm going to have to say Mark.
I'm a Star Wars guy. I had Star Wars wallpaper since I was 13, 14, 15 years old.
Really?
Yeah.
That's awesome.
I need to bring that back. I'll show you that.
That's fantastic. We have a Christmas tree. Wade has like all these Star Wars ornaments, so we're fully invested in the Star Wars. So keeping on that theme then, top five of your favorite movies, top five movies. Could be dramas, could be comedies, could be...
Okay. Now Star Wars is on the mind.
Yeah.
I will go with Star Wars. And then I would go with some of the Rockies.
Mm-hmm.
I'll go Rocky 1. And then I would go with, Bloodsport.
Of course. That's Kumite.
Kumite. Oh, that was awesome. And then I'll go with, Top Gun.
Nice.
That's a good one for me. Just recently I watched Cars 2 with my kids.
Mm-hmm.
The reason why I like that so much is because it had a lot of like kind of lessons to kind of teach the kids.
Mm-hmm.
And so I kind of like that for the kids too. So that one and Dumb and Dumber, I love that movie and I love to laugh.
That's your Ellenberger connection too, because I know he loves that movie.
Yes, yes.
His head fell off.
Yes.
He was old.
Yeah.
You know, right?
Yeah.
Love that movie too.
Yeah.
So, top five records then, album or, downloads or whatever, your favorite five.
I would say, top five downloads, like songs?
Or just, songs, albums, complete, whatever.
Man.
Just because, no, I don't know your taste in music.
It's all around the place. So, I would have to go with, you probably don't know this about me, but I'd probably go with Tupac.
No.
Yeah.
Nice.
All Eyes on Me.
Yeah.
I grew up on that stuff. E-40.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah,
E-40. You are a Californian boy.
I'm a Californian boy.
Yeah.
I grew up on that stuff. And then I grew up and started listening to like contemporary Christian type stuff, which, Chris Tomlin, I love. Hillsong, I love. I like listening to some country music.
That's cool.
Because I went to Oklahoma State.
Yeah.
And I listened to some country. And I know Garth Brooks because he went to Oklahoma State.
Yeah.
And he brought me to the backstage of his concert. And I became a fan ever since.
Garth was obviously doing some stuff right. So it's not like...
And he wrestled too. So
did he really?
That's points right there for him. So I'm... Yeah, but I'm all over the place, man. I listen to a lot of. I'm the type of guy that likes to groove. I like to dance, I like.
Oh, that was one of my questions. Like, when you get to the club, you dance.
Yeah, I dance. Oh, I dance. You ask anybody, I'm in my own groove, because I'm just dancing, because that's what I like to do, I come from the Filipino culture, and I love to dance, and my culture loves to dance, and I actually choreographed a lot of cotillions. That's a coming out party for girls that are turning 18 years old, that are kind of going into womanhood. So that's why we have parties, and I used to choreograph cotillions, which is the waltz and the cha-cha, and then they used to dance and stuff like that. So you didn't know that fun, fun fact about me. I used to make money with that and stuff, and
fantastic.
So if you ever want a cha-cha, I will cha-cha, I will waltz, I'll do all that. I can teach you. I can teach you a choreographer for that, for sure.
Sign me up.
So
I think that's
Dancing
fantastic.
With the Stars. Here I come.
Did you see any big knocks down at the Brazilian?
I haven't heard about it.
I heard they were just like.
I heard he was stiff.
Exactly.
Classic Nogueira.
He's good at the robot.
I love you, Nogueira.
Yeah, we love Nogueira, but I guess the robot was maybe like the extent. That's classic. Okay, so do you remember the first concert you ever went to then?
First concert I ever went to, yes. It was actually a Christian concert.
Yeah.
It was a Stephen Curtis Chapman concert that I went to. I didn't go to many concerts when I was younger, but I did go to that one.
Was it a big arena show? Or was it
a big arena show.
Yeah.
It was at UC Davis at their big arena there. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, it was fun.
Nice.
It was very, very
nice.
Fun.
Yeah. And I think I have a couple more entertainment things. Is there, what's, you know, if we go to your house and we turn on your DVR, what's the thing where you're like, oh, no, that's not mine. You know what I mean? You know there's a guilty pleasure. They're like, yeah, you know.
I like to watch cooking shows.
Well, you love your food, my God.
I love
God.
My food.
What do you think?
I love my food.
So, but are you watching Rachel Ray or are you watching, you
no,
know,
I'm
like
watching,
the...
I'm watching Top Chef.
Yeah.
You know, I'm watching, see, I'm drawing a blank now. The guy that eats, like,
Anthony Bourdain around.
Yes.
Yeah.
I watch him.
Joe Rogan loves him too. That's his.
I just can't believe what he puts in his mouth sometimes. But you know, I'd love to have that. I'd love to have that show.
Yeah.
Because I would eat anything. If someone eats it around the world, I'll probably taste it. But I probably won't like it. I'll taste it though. But that's a great job.
It is a great job. Which leads me to not fine dining. If you had to choose Taco Bell, In-N-Out, or KFC.
In-N-Out.
Yeah. Dude, come on.
In-N-Out for
come
sure.
On.
In-N-Out for sure. Animal style, everything.
Totally. I'm so right there with you. So I think I'm trying to give there. So on your food, what's the one thing that you hate to give up the most for camp? You know, you miss it the most.
White rice.
Really?
Because I grew up on white rice.
Yeah.
When I was younger, I mean, we had a big pot of rice and kind of just like a little bit of like... you know, meat or
right,
whatever.
Right.
And so I would just eat a lot of rice and a little bit of meat.
Yeah.
And that's what I would be satisfied with. Now I can't eat white rice because it kind of stores as fat.
Yeah.
And so I got to eat better carbs that's quinoa and brown rice noodles and things of that sort. So white rice I have to, you know. But after...
That's my next question. What's your reward meal after the fight?
After, it would be my mom's Filipino cuisine.
Yeah.
And then it'll be sushi. And it'll be In-N-Out. That's my top three.
It's fantastic.
And BJ's Pizza, that's another one.
That's good.
Thai food, that's another one too. I love my food.
What I love about you, now Christoph's got you down to Tupperwares. And
yeah,
I know. You're getting old.
You get mad and upset and like, do another Tupperware meal. No, it's actually good food.
It is. It is. I know. It's working for him.
Yeah.
So do you, do you remember your pickup line to Christy, your wife?
I got a lot of corny pickup lines.
Yeah.
I'm like, can I borrow your watch? So I can spend time with you.
Oh my God!
I said, you remind me of my broom. Did you sweep me off my feet?
Like, and these worked. They have four children.
No, but you know what? Yes, they did work. But I used them in a good context.
Yeah.
I didn't like the first time. First time I saw her, I didn't be like, yo, can I borrow your watch? I didn't do that. It was on a date, and you know, it's kind of like, you know, kind of stuff like that.
That's cute.
Yeah, so.
That's endearing. So on a roller coaster, yes or no? Let's say you were on a date in a music park. Yes or no roller coaster?
I could do a roller coaster probably like 5 times, and that's my limit.
Cause, oh, yeah.
Because now it's like, how do I get dizzy now? When
it's
I was
weird.
Younger, when I was younger, I would run just to get back in line.
Exactly.
Again. Now it's like, it's kind of weird when you get older.
I know your balance or something is totally
it's
different.
Weird.
And your
weird.
Balance obviously is fantastic, but
it's the weirdest thing. Kids are going back on them. They're like, Dad, let's go. I'm like, guys, go ahead. I'll wait right here for you.
Yeah. Hold the bags. All right. So what's your favorite vacation spot?
Ooh, I got a bunch.
Yeah.
I love Montana.
You fish?
I fish.
Yeah.
Yes, I love hiking.
Mm-hmm.
I love the mountains.
Mm-hmm.
But I also like Hawaii.
Yeah.
I'm going to the Philippines this summer.
Of course.
So I'm going to Boracay. That's how they say it over there. Boracay. And I'm going to bring my daughter with me. And it's paradise out there.
Mm-hmm.
So I love visiting the Philippines and my family out there too. That would be actually my top three. I love the Napa Valley, going visiting vineyards and wine tasting, although I don't drink.
Right.
I love like the different tastes in the wine and stuff, but I never crave it or anything like that. It's just like you kind of get into it, and people are like,
the whole experience,
you know, looking all at the thing, and I'm like, man, what? And then me just asking questions like, why do you do that? And then I'm like, oh wow, this is a good,
it's
has
good.
A good tart to it, good taste to it, and yeah, so I got into it a little bit.
Yeah, I do like to drink my wine, so anything, you just pass it to me after you do the whole experience.
There you go.
I know after a fight, you reward yourself with family time and stuff like this, but has there been one material thing that you were like, you know what, I got a fight bonus and I really, really, really wanted this, so I bought it, you know?
You know what, I paid for a vacation.
Yeah.
Just because I didn't spend a lot of time with my family. Mm-hmm. And so I took the family and we went on a trip. So I'm like, I got this bonus. We're going to spend a lot of money and we're going to have a lot of fun. And we're going on this trip. So we went to Montana and mm-hmm. we went on this trip. We spent a lot of money. But it was a lot of fun and we had a lot of fun family memories, you know,
exactly.
because of that. So... you know, but at the same time, you know, I'm a frugal guy.
Yeah.
Know? I like to keep my money and kind of spend it and invest it wisely. Sure. But there's times where you have to do that.
For sure. Well, you have four children. You can't be.
Yeah.
All right. So I think we're almost done. I think, have you ever puked before a fight?
Never.
No.
Never puked before a wrestling match either. But I've seen other guys that puked after they wrestled me. I don't know about after they fought me, but
yeah, I'm sure
they probably did.
I'm willing to bet. I'm willing to bet. What's the best part of being a fighter?
The fact that you can enrich those that are around you through what you have in your life. So I opened up the gym, Rain Training Center, and I basically show the guys who I am as a person, who I am as a fighter, and as a person too. And I try to give as much as I can. So, and they see me, how I train in here. They see how I fight inside the octagon. And that kind of gives me stock in them. And for me, it's not about the fame and the fortune and the glory about fighting, but it's how you can use that and improve their quality of life, the state that they're in right now, and be able to breathe life and, you know, success in them after fighting, because fighting only lasts for 5, 6, 7 years at most, and then you're gonna start a family, and then you're gonna work or start a business or what have you. The things that you actually learn through fighting, like perseverance, character, integrity, leadership, heart, you know, those are the things that you need, you know, discipline mm-hmm. and desire,
yeah, your
direction,
knees. Yeah,
diligence,
right.
Discipline, dedication, you know, those are the things that you need in order to be successful, and I like doing that.
Yeah.
And I love pouring into people and investing in them and investing time, and I love doing that. And so when I'm done, I'm going to coach. I'm a coach and try to lead guys to where they want to achieve their goals. And you know, attaining a belt is not the end. It's not the end of all end for people. And that's why I think people see it. Oh, when I get a belt, everything's going to be cool. But it's not.
Then what?
It's not. Then what?
Right.
You know, win the belt, but use that. Use that to be able to help other people so that your legacy can live on, because you're helping other people, and they can help other people, and they can help other people, you know? So that's what I like about fighting.
The worst part being what? The injuries or the what?
Yeah, it's injuries. It's injuries and the time spent away from the people that you love. That's hard.
Yeah.
That is hard.
I would imagine. And I think my last question here is, do you remember the first time you got recognized as a pro fighter?
Yeah. When I was fighting, yeah.
Yeah? Yeah? I mean, what happened?
So someone goes, you're Mark Munoz. Dude, I just saw you get kicked in the head by Matt Hamill.
No.
I go, oh, wow, that's my claim to fame right there.
Oh, you know? Man. But look at all you've accomplished since that.
I know. And that's why I told him, I said, champions aren't measured by how many wins they have, but how many times they pick themselves up after a loss. And trust me, I'm coming back. So now I'm here. and Matt Hamill's retired, and I'm here to stay, and I'm knocking on the door of a world title. So, you know, I think a lot of people need to be persevering and need to have endurance to be able to run that race and run it the hardest you can, and by the end, you'll have something to show for it. So.
Awesome. Yeah. Well, I think you're going to be recognized for years to come. So, thank you for answering my ridiculous questions.
It's no problem.
It's always great to see you, Mark.
Good to see you, too.